In this video, we're going to show you quick and easy ways to duplicate objects in your simulation model. Let's start by creating a simple model. Drag out a source, a processor, a conveyor, and a sink, and connect these objects starting with the source and ending at the sink. Click the source to access its quick properties and give it an inner arrival time of 0, giving us an infinite supply of flow items. In the processor's quick properties, change its process time to 3. If you click Reset and Run, you'll see the processor begin to process items at a rapid pace. Let's add a few more processors to the model, and we want them to be identical to the first processor. I know that all they really require is a simple change in process time, but in most models, objects have many parameters that have been customized, so duplication is the best option. To copy, simply click on the processor to highlight it. This is denoted by a yellow box around the object. Hold the Control key and press the C key on your keyboard. Then move your mouse to wherever you want the copy to be made, hold the Control key and press the V key. Just like that, the processor has been duplicated, retaining all of its parameters. Alternatively, you can right-click on an object, point to Edit, and then click Copy to copy an object. Right-click anywhere in the model, point to Edit, and then click Paste to make a duplicate of the object at that location. Connect our two new processors to the model, and then reset and run the model. The processors all have the same process times, so they are moving flow items at a high rate. But let's say we end up editing one of the processors. Double-click on the processor to open its properties window, and then find the Triggers tab. Click the green plus sign for On Entry to add an action to that trigger, and select Set Item Type and Color from the list. Click OK to save and close the window. If you reset and run the model, you'll see that only one of the processors is producing colorful items. We can copy this and any other parameter onto our other processors without deleting and recreating them. First, we need to select the objects we want to copy to. Hold the Control key and click to select the other two processors. Be aware that selected objects will always have a red box around them, even if they are highlighted. Click View in the menu bar and choose Edit Selected Objects. This is a very powerful utility with many options, but for right now we're concerned with the Copy from Highlighted section. You can copy any and all parameters from an object, including variables, labels, location, rotation and size, and visual elements. We need something to copy from, so click to highlight the first processor, giving it a yellow box. Access the variable drop-down menu and select Entry Trigger from the list. Then click the Variable button. Reset and run the model. All of our processors are now working with colored flow items because we successfully copied that trigger to the other two processors. Using the Edit Selected Objects utility is a convenient way to copy widespread or complex changes to many objects at once. Thank you for watching. For more information on FlexSim products or to view more tips and tricks for successful modeling, please visit www.flexsim.com.